Alright guys, welcome back to Let's Play 2, the Ilvard Insurrection. Last time we left off, Thermidor betrayed Zahar and awakened Lucian inside of Mia. And of course, Ilvard is in grave danger, so you know what that means. Side quests! Yes, because of course, the world is in imminent danger, we just have to put that aside and do some side quests. By the way... Oh, what is it? Well, Grain has been looking into something. You know those doors in all the dungeons that never open? The other day he found one of them sitting there, open. According to most sources, they've been sealed since the Great War. For them to open now, I'm betting it has something to do with Melchizedek showing up. Might have to check that out later. But first, since last time I actually went ahead and got 360 hunter points, Ragna. So that puts me at the Truth Seeker.
I deserve this.
And we get a shortcake for reaching 330. And more importantly, the Giver's Beard, which increases item drops, which will be pretty important, especially if you want to get all the capsules. So, at this point, the max hunter point you could get is 390. So you have a bit of a leeway, you don't have to platinum everything. So, that's good news. That's definitely... some guy in a swanky suit? If you could all listen up, I have an announcement. Lady Fiona has just informed me of the dangers presented by the tornado. So here's what I'm thinking. First, we should set up some barricades around the streets and, so yeah, Maurice is actually the mayor of the town. Who would have thought? I'm sorry, I've been neglecting you all lately. Looks like you are in need of some serious running. I relay intelligence to Master Tenzin if anything happens, inform Karasu or myself. We'll be sure to deliver the message to the hamlet safely. We'll keep you in the loop. What do you think they use? Maybe a carrier pigeon? I don't know. I can't be sure these branches will fare well against the brunt of the oncoming storm. Perhaps I can replant these elsewhere. It seems like his love for plants wasn't just a cover after all. Huh. Looks like it. Dad is giving a speech. He's not very good at it. But he does look kinda cool. That suit should have stayed buried in the closet forever though. It doesn't look that bad on him. Come on, give the guy a break. Everyone's up in a panic about the big tornado. I'm gonna have to close up shop soon too. Oh, before I forget. Hippy stopped by earlier and had me put some real cute pieces on reserve, but all she'd tell me was, just leave it to me, I'll take care of everything. What do you think she meant by that? I don't suppose you know anything, Alwen. Oh, I think I could hazard a guess. No one in this town would feel the loss of fashion more keenly than Pipiro.
Heya, welcome!
Actually, there are some new pieces of equipment in here available that, like the scarf and the ribbon. The scarf is pretty nice, it gives plus 2 magic. Might as well buy the ribbon as well.
Toodles.
I should probably turn in the treasure chest as well, just to get a bit more penny.
Yeah.
Well, shucks, finally finished up my mission here, then this blows in right out of nowhere. I know Lord Daigle would have some choice words for me if I were to turn tail now. So you better believe I'm all in with ya, to the bitter end, fellas.
Hell yeah, that's what I'd like to hear.
I'm pretty interested in seeing this power your clan wields firsthand. Oh, trust me, we'll see it in spades.
Actually, we won't.
Looks like I'm hauling the old lady. Well, I'll bet she's been cruising around on that rickety broom long enough to that she won't faint if I pour on the speed. Look alive, Beowulf. We are going for a ride.
Only Odessa's plane needs refueling, but we'll have it topped up soon, no need to worry. By the way, There's this little pigeon who's been helping me out with my work here recently. He'll take a look at the aeroplanes, then bring me the parts I need. Really? Dang, that's one short pigeon. It's true, I do like the little guy, I suppose I should give him a name. Oh, what do you think of Coco? I'm thinking maybe go with the next name on your list. That was the best you could think of? What? You mean to say you don't like it? Actually, if you talk to the pigeon, he gives you a few tips on the dungeons, but I already did most of them. Hey, you guys. I just wanted to say thank you for returning the rainbow jewel to us. Oh, don't mention it, man. It was just sitting there and it seemed wrong to just leave it lying around. But it looks like all the magic's been sucked right out of it, huh? Seems so, the brilliant luster is totally gone. Probably tapped out from all the big rituals they used it in. I guess even something as legendary as the Goddess Orb can't hold infinite power. True, but don't you worry. It was like this once before, so I'd figure it'll bounce back to normal sooner or later. Yep, I think it took about 6 months last time. Wow, you guys are practically experts at that thing. Oh, by the way, I wanted to ask. I noticed this Albatross Corp light aeroplane when I stopped by the airstrip before. It's yours, right? Spot on. A pilot we knew recommended it to us. They say practically anyone can fly this model, and hey, the price was right too.
Price was right, my ass. We blew the entire 100,000 penne we got from Pneuma on this thing.
What's a Pneuma?
And even with all that, Tiara and the mayor had to front up some cash.
Well, aeroplanes are expensive and I thought you were all in the favor for it. After all, who's the one who said she was tired of the mail carrier only coming twice a year?
Who wouldn't be?
At least now I have a trusty chauffeur to fly me around whenever I feel like buying some new clothes.
But I thought you said I didn't have to be your chauffeur. This design is pretty strange. It looks kind of like a bird, don't you think? Oh, you're right, it does. Except for those extra wings though, I'd never seen a bird like that.
Oh, but that's the coolest part. It might not be the fastest plane in the sky, but the handling's smooth and it's pretty stable, if you ask me. They set the standard for every entry-level plane that's been designed since. It's a classic.
Oh.
You sure know a ton about aeroplanes. Of course I do. I was born to fly. Coco, Pipiro. This strategy is all about formation, so don't worry about your speed. You won't have to worry about keeping up, so just focus on your balance and steering. Got it. Alright. And that upgraded Popple's final character note. Time to get Claude's. Holy cannoli! Is that the Lord Valens? The plane designed and custom built by the legendary engineer himself?
I figured you might recognize it. It was indeed built by a member of my family, my great uncle. He was quite the eccentric. I'm just borrowing it though. The family granted permission for me to use it for my mission.
Really? Well, you still got to fly in it. And that's awesome. Let me guess, the butler's also your pilot, right? Indeed. Sumptuous as it may be, I've been allowed the honor of piloting this fine craft.
Claude is a quite skilled aviator. He once took first place in a local air race championship, actually.
Milady, that was a long time ago.
Is that so? Wouldn't mind a friendly race with you, one of these days.
Hey, is that... Whoa, for such a classy looking airframe, you're packing some serious turbo muscle, it's like a work of art. What kind of build is this anyway?
is designed to facilitate maximum stability at the highest speeds. Guess he's still a kid at heart. Seriously, look at him whip himself into a frenzy over an aeroplane. It's embarrassing.
We were actually missing two character notes for Claude, but that last one actually updated both of them. Go figure.
If we focus our magic on a single spot, we should be able to tear open a rift in the tornado. But if we flap this chance, I doubt we'll get a second go. Whatever the case, you'd better make sure you're ready for everything.
Yeah, I hear you. Still, it's kinda unnerving that I can see the tornado so easily even from here.
Yeah, it's scary sight. The Spiral Fortress, Melchizedek. If the stories have the right of it, the floating stronghold has laid waste to many islands, even continents. Here I thought it was relegated to the dusty pages of history, but here it is, right in front of us. It sure surprised me, you can bet your bloomers on that. True, but I wouldn't expect anything less from the castle of a demon lord. Sadly, my own castle doesn't have that level of power. Though I'd certainly do more than cram my style if we were to lose now. My princess?
Well, good thing we ain't planning on losing here. Let's check out that door that Caldina was talking about, why not? There is one in the mines anyway and it's on the way to Ralta. Oh hey.
Oh poop, we are in big trouble, the seal's been broken.
What seal?
This isn't good, and with Monsieur too. Monsieur out too, who's going to fix this?
Why are you trying to fix that? It was fine as it was.
Goodness. Goodness me. I'm really worried now. How could something like this happen? My main number one job was to make sure the seal was never broken. And I never neglected my silly duties, did I? Never!
And that's actually the third character note for the service penguin. If we look at him, or her, the second one isn't filled in yet, he'll be doing that later.
The chief is Bigum, praying. A Jovian victim, you know?
The reason I can stay here in the village is cause everyone here is always praying for me.
Huh. If that's true, that means you'd have to be... There's nothing I wouldn't do to help this village out. That's cause I love Roalta.
What was that all about? Let's see here, Wade. Wade. He's actually a spirit who resides in Roalta village. Huh. So, maybe normal people can't even see him? Interesting.
Alright then, I'll just leave these vegetables here. Frederica is out drawing some water for you. Thank you, dearie. You're both going to so much trouble just for me. Think nothing of it. That's what neighbors are for. If you need anything at all, you just ask me, okay? Thinking back, I remember a day not so different from this one. It must have been, 100 years ago. There was a terrible storm, nastiest winds I ever saw in my life. I was just a wee lass back then myself, but I remember how wild that storm was, and how we pulled through then. So don't you worry. The goddess and her spirit helped us 100 years ago, and they'll help us now.
Yeah, that's good to hear.
So, this really weird guy came by like just now, super muscly, way too enthusiastic about exercises.
A muscle man, you say?
I wish I had no idea who she was talking about, but I'm afraid I know exactly who she's talking about. Of all the disturbing things I could have seen, it's like I was trapped in a scary dream, but there I was, wide awake. I sympathize completely. You don't have to tell me twice. Huh. Interesting. The heck is Galindo doing all the way out here? Oh hey, the fairies finally opened their shop. Whoa, customers already? Hey Marin, some people actually came to buy our stuff. Hello friends and welcome. You guys? Rue? Marin? Ricky? What are you all doing here? Hey, what about me? Spirit the thought for old Joe, eh? Nice to see you, Rue. What you been up to these days? Guess that human who caught you ended up selling you for a pretty penny, huh?
Oh, so it was Rue you were talking about.
I mean, okay, I did get caught, but I snuck out that Cajun the first chance I got. After that, well, a lot happened. It's hard out there for a fairy. I tried my hardest to get back to all of you, but I got stuck in a crate that got loaded onto an aeroplane.
I never knew.
I thought I'd never see you again. I'm sorry the world was so cruel to you, Rue. You guys. Wow, I never knew you had it that rough before you found your way to Ilvard. Why didn't you ever tell me? I'm sorry, my princess. It's just, it was a bad time. The less I have to dwell on it, the better. Getting snatched up by that nasty, odious human before I even knew what was happening. It makes me sick to my stomach just thinking about it.
Yeah, okay, I saw you looking straight at me as you were saying that. I get it. You hate humans. Can't say I blame you. After hearing what happened.
Of course, but just so you know, I hated humans long before that. Why do I even try? It probably doesn't seem like it to you, but her attitude towards humans has actually been softening lately. Still, I don't realize all of you fairies were Rue's friends. I'm glad you were finally reunited, after all this time apart.
Yeah, it's a wide world out there, running into your old past just out of the blue, like this is a sweet stroke of luck. It's all aces for you, Rue.
What, do you think getting sympathy and encouragement from a human would make me happy? But hey, you guys really went and did it. You opened your own store.
You always used to go on about how you were going to. One of these days. Yep, it's taken us quite a while to work out all the details, but we finally did it.
Say, since you're already here, why not take a look at our totally cool and trendy wares, Lady Trueblood? Sure, we just opened, but we have already got some fairy goods deals, if I say so myself. Certainly, I'm eager to see what you have in stock. Whatever it is, I'm sure it'll prove amusing, or at the very least.
Well, they got some neat stuff. Actually, we can get a pet we were missing earlier. And this is pretty nice, it boosts Alwyn's magic, so let's get that. The accelerating increases your movement. It's okay. And the worm powder is a item. It's the last item that boosts your experience.
Thank you so much for your purchase.
Though when the shop description said fairy, did that mean?
Of course! Your new fairy friend is none other than me, the lovely and talented Marin. See, we've been thinking about how to thank you for a while, Lady Trueblood, and we decided that, as the eldest, it falls to me to join you guys on your thrilling adventures. Aren't you excited? I'm excited. So, whenever you want some company, don't hesitate to call on me. No matter the time, no matter the place, I'll be there.
Oh, thanks. She can actually heal us. It's okay, foods are better. Oh, hey, look who I found.
No way. There's no way Master Zahar could be dead. What should I do?
Oh, she's been hanging around here, huh?
Jim seems pretty miserable. With my uncle dead and gone, she's probably lost a lot of her magic. Let's just leave her be. I don't think she'll be much of a threat.
Well, if you say so. Maybe we'll check back on her later. We are still missing a character note for her.
Welcome.
I heard the whole thing. You're actually planning on infiltrating the giant fortress, aren't you? Melchizedek's existence was recorded in ancient documents. And if a tornado with that much magical energy pulled us in, it'd tear this continent apart. Ilvard was hit by just such an attack once, and the land sustained massive damage from it. I can't say what's waiting within. I doubt anyone alive can. Be careful. Thanks on the vote of confidence. Let's see, we'll be sure to do our best, but first of all, let me just buy that tabby. The more magic I can get, the better. I'll worry about buying the armor pieces later. I want to save my money.
You're that traveler who lost his way before, right? Long time no see.
No kidding. What are you doing out here anyway?
I can explain. See, I was wandering around Ilvard when all of a sudden it started snowing. Pretty soon, I was in the middle of a full-blown snowstorm, so I just kept on walking until I reached this hamlet. So like, maybe you can tell me where am I anyway? Hold it. You're not trying to tell me you just blindly stumbled into a hidden village in the heart of Starry Peak, are you? How in the world did you survive that trip? The monsters, the elements. You've got one fantastic sense of direction, that's for sure.
Anyway, you should count your lucky stars you didn't fall into some ravine or catch hypothermia out there.
I'm good to go.
I mean, I never even saw this snowstorm coming. Ilvard's weather sure is fickle. Before that, it was super windy. Maybe I'll head south next.
There you are, I've been looking all over for you. Huh? What are you doing all the way out here? Oh, it's you again. I was thinking about how the mood of the village has changed lately. With everything that's been going on, I never had the time to slow down and introspect on it till now. Our long-standing duty as guardians has come to an end. I never imagined I'd see the day. Maybe it's because of that, but whether or not it is, the whole atmosphere is different now. And to be honest, no one's really sure what's the best for us going forward. We've lived our whole lives as ninja, but none of our training prepared us for this kind of challenge. But I want Ruri and the other generation to be able to live their lives however they see fit. Huh? What's so amusing? Well, what you said just made me realize that you have changed quite a bit too. Say what you like, I don't think I've changed that much. My orders from Master Tanzin still stand too, so I'll keep protecting the village as best I can. Looks like another outsider has wandered in here from the mountain. We've got him in custody now, so I'll be questioning him later. You do that.
Oh my Ragna, dearie. Did you come to enjoy a nice hot soak? Oh, you're always more than welcome to. At times like these, a relaxing bath is just what you need to soothe the aches and pains.
You said it. Oh yeah, thanks for looking after Subaru before. I really owe you one.
Oh, don't you go worrying yourself over something like that. My darling Subaru is like a daughter to me. It's only second nature to look after her. By the way, I've been meaning to ask. When are you planning on having the ceremony? Have you sent invitations?
Huh?
I mean, The last thing I want is to sound pushy or anything, but... Subaru is going to be 15 soon, coming right into the flower of her womanhood. Oh my, don't tell me you haven't even thought about it at all, Ragna dearie. Oh, well, quite a smooth operator, aren't you, Ragna?
I guess I should have explained that before we came here, huh?
You are the worst. Actually, I married into this community too. That's why I can totally understand your hesitation, Ragna dearie. But things go smoother for everyone when you plan for your special day well in advance. Don't you think Subaru will look positively adorable in her wedding gown? Just thinking about it melts my heart.
I'm digging myself deeper into this hole every minute. I gotta clear this misunderstanding somehow. Well, maybe a nice bath would do it.
I'll handle this!
Even Rue joins in. And of course there is another scene with Ragna, so let me just skip to the part where I get it. And 7 is my lucky number, apparently. It's not much different from Odessa's. And goodbye, pedometer. You have been a long companion on my journey, but it's time to say goodbye. And it's time to continue the trade sequence with Lotte. Something up?
Something up? I don't know what you're talking about. Ignorance will get you nowhere, you know. Could it be this fox tail that's got you in a fizzy? Might I suggest a little test, princess? You read my mind. Behold, you are now powerless before my ultimate might. Could you cut it out? It's totally distracting.
Oh, a likely excuse. I think there's something deeper. Care to amend your statement? Wait, are you telling me that she's a real cat girl?
Hey, guess what? I just had the perfect idea. How about you trade that foxtail with me? I need it. It looks like such fun. I can swap you for something I got through my special connection. It's pretty sweet, guys. Everyone's gonna want one.
Sure, take it.
Booyah, it's a deal then.
Running shears?
See, aren't they pretty sweet? With the sleek long handles, you can even reach those pesky high branches.
Pretty sweet, my ass. This is just something you randomly bought on impulse. Alright, next. Let's go back to Starfall Hamlet. This is a weird one, it's the only character that is involved in this side quest that isn't named.
It's so embarrassing. I want to confess my true feelings to Akane, but I think she'll always just see me as one of her pupils.
Well, maybe trying a different outfit from the rest of the ninjas would help.
But even if I told her I love her, she'd probably just laugh it off. Could I cope with such crushing rejection? I don't know.
Wow, never noticed he was so stuck on her. Good luck, man.
Oh, those wouldn't happen to be poor pruning shears you got with you, would they?
Yes, that's exactly what I need. My prayers have been answered.
A Connie's father, Jen, has a huge green thumb, really a hell of a gardener. If I give you a nice pair of shears, like those as a present, that'll get me a big time brownie points for sure. So, how about it? Will you be a pal and let me have them? Sure, good luck, buddy. Thanks, your timing was just perfect. I really appreciate your generosity. Here, I want you to have this. Oh, a shuriken. Thanks. Do you really think that pair of shears will do the trick, huh? Don't worry, as you can see, I'm a ninja. As long as passion burns in my heart, I'll keep at it no matter how long it takes. Well, good for you, but that sounds more like stalking to me. Maybe, but she's a ninja too, so I guess it all evens out. Goodness gracious, you've got something mighty special there. From the youngest types to the oldest geezers, there's no man who doesn't dream of having his own shuriken to throw. It isn't often you come by something that unique, I gotta say. Oh, what do you youngsters say? Would you consider with parting with that shuriken of yours? Consider it yours! Oh, when I woke up this morning, I never dreamed today would be my lucky day. My, my, this is really well made, it looks so authentic too. It's real, buddy. Oh yes, why don't you take this in exchange? Now it's your lucky day too. A voice modulator? With this, I have no doubt you'll raise your intention of superstardom. I don't really want to. Where the heck did he think I'd bust out something like this? Well, we actually need it for back in Arte. Bear us away. We are almost done. Almost. Oh! Hey, you two! That wouldn't happen to be a real voice modulator you've got there, would it? Just imagine me roaming the streets with a rich supply of silly voices. It could be just a thing I need to win over some new fans. Please, guys, you've just gotta let me have it. Sure. Sweet! I just knew you would. Okay, here, take this wonderful gift. My little way of saying thanks. A bandage? When you are training to be a performer like me, you got all sorts of cuts and scrapes. Bandages are a must. But now that I'm a pro, I don't really have much need for them. Right, guess it couldn't hurt to have one on hand. Though with the way my body is now, any wound I would get would just close up by the time I finish bandaging it. Oh, so that's the perk of the blood contract,
one,
huh?
Two, three, four.
And back to Starfall Hamlet. Dude, this frostbite is kinda starting to get to me. Whoa, stop the presses, is that the bandage you got there? Ooh, I'm saved. Provided you'd be willing to part with it, that is. Here, it looks like you need it. You saved my life, literally. I'm always getting banged up like this, somehow it happens so often, I'm just used to it to now. Like this one time I was walking on this mountain ridge, and it just broke away from the mountains and I slid down. It was pretty scary. All told, I sure got my share of cuts and bruises that time. Yeesh, nice save there. How are you even still alive? You're either the dumbest human alive, or the luckiest, possibly both. Alright, you really did me a solid, so I should give you something. Oh, here we go. How about I give you my map? I was told it's very accurate, great for travelers. I know you two could put it to good use. A map of Arges? Buddy, this is Zwei 2, not 1. Arges? Oh, Arges, it's the continent to the southwest of the frontier. Wait, you couldn't have been. Please tell me you weren't using this map to guide yourself around Ilvard. Of course I was. That's what a map is for, isn't it? See those little marks I penciled in? Those are where I camped out. Right now, we are here, near those ruins you see on the lower right. That's incredible. How can one guy be that inept? Princess, we should leave. If we stay here any longer, I'm afraid his idiocy would rub off on us. True, his body may make a full recovery, but I'm afraid his sense of direction died a long time ago. Only one... Actually, that was the last item, but we have to trade that for one more item. Oh, it's you, back in town, huh? So it seems. Master Tenzin instructed me to give you any aid I was able. I'm unable to aid you in more direct manner as the hamlet is best kept hidden from the world at large, but... If you run into any problem, just tell me. Alright, will do. By the by, it seems you've come into a possession of something rather interesting there. It looks like a map of Arges. Wow, you can tell without me even unrolling it, huh? That's pretty impressive, honestly. Arges is a minor continent and, well, pretty out of the way. It was long been my task to gather intelligence. Multiple disguises and journeys to other continents are nothing new. Though, thus far, I've had no reason to travel to Arges. Now then, what would you say to give me that map? By all means. Oh, you are most generous, alright. In trade for the map, please accept
this.
The F parts. Would you like to hear something interesting about Arges? About a year ago, something rather ominous transpired in that land. One of the six demon lords of old, Vesper the Boundless, was awakened from where he'd been sealed away there. Wow, really? A demon lord? Well, strictly speaking, it's just a rumor. I've neither seen nor heard anything that would directly corroborate that account. But when I look at the current situation, my doubts about what went down in Arges begin to waver. Dissolution the Gilded seems to have been freed from his ceiling and with her immense powers fully intact. It's up to you to put an end to this. Make sure you've accounted for every contingency before you face her. Thanks for the parts, by the way. That's actually Ragna's best weapon. Wow. The transformation from sad wreck to working aeroplane seems to be coming along swimmingly. Oh, there you are. Gotta say, I'm impressed. You're practically flying through the repairs. I figured you'd come here asking for our help sooner or later, so I went ahead and set aside the parts you need in advance. Still, I don't think fixing your plane would end up being this much of a rush job.
Damn straight. Boy, if you walk into my shop and asked us to finish everything this fast, I would have clocked you upside the head with a crescent wrench. Still, considering the circumstances and all, I'll cut you some slack this time.
Thanks. We found a bunch of stuff already patched up when we got here. You do all that yourself? You ain't no mechanic, but this works not half bad. If I say so. Well, I ain't exactly rich, so knowing how to do some basic maintenance has saved me plenty of cash. Anyway, how much longer do you think it's gonna take before she's skyworthy? Let's see. I'd wager around an hour, give or take. I wanna give the engine one final check before you take her up. How are you feeling? Are you ready to
get back behind the stick. Well, I still need to prepare. Alright, we'll be here whenever you're ready. When the repairs are done, we'll give the engine one final inspection. Roger that. I'm just here to talk to Kessler.
Hey, kiddo, what you got cooking?
Oh, what you got there? Another one of the Magistone gizmos. Gotta say, you dug in some real strange parts this time, boy. I mean, what in the deep sky is this? Looks like it's some sort of weapon. Yeah? What kind of weapon? Well, this is what I think it is. These things were real hair razors back during the Great War. Never seen one myself, mind ya. All I know is that folks back then used them to defend Ilvard. It takes some real doing, but I can probably figure out a way to install these in that anchor gears of yours. Sure, make it cooler. Alright, just keep your panties on. I'll be done in 3 shakes. Oh damn, I ain't never laid hands on parts that ornery. I ought to be charging your ass for this complicated, you know. Wait, so you really were able to install in my anchor gear? Of course. Did you doubt the great Gashler ever even for a moment? But I gotta say, this thing's hardly even looking like an anchor gear anymore. Got more of the Magistone parts in there than one original part now. I doubt I can make it much better than this. The Spiral Gear, Ragna's ultimate weapon. It's pretty powerful. Wow, so this is what the anchor gear looks like if you upgrade it with a bunch of old Magistone parts. I gotta admit, this thing looks totally sweet. Thanks a million, Mr. Gashler, for this and everything, really. Just lending a hand where it's needed, that's all. That anchor gear's been a damn fine piece of machinery, holding up like a real champ after all them upgrades. Ragna, my boy, clean out that earwax, cause I'm only gonna tell you once. You better take damn good care of it. This thing's one kind now. You better believe I will. Again, I really appreciate everything you have done for me, Mr. Gashler. You're an all-star. No Shrek references. Oh, and if you want to buy anything, you have to talk to Gashler.
Don't be a stranger now!
It does look pretty sweet with the neon colors and all. Alright, let's next go back to the Colosseum. Alright, I equipped everything that boosts my magic for the ultimate fight. The fight that I couldn't win the first time we were here. Claude. Sure, let's do this first. I'm getting ahead of myself. Well met, Lady Alwen. I wouldn't have expected to see you in such a strange place.
Allow me.
I don't even know what his moveset is, since I'm pretty going to kill him pretty fast, so who cares. As you can see, my MP is not going down at all. That's thanks to the towels that we got from the raiding in all the hunter points. And after you take even one piece of damage, you can't use it anymore, but you can just heal that up.
Congratulations!
Oh yeah, Galindo isn't here, so yeah. And we get the Z-Pod. It's just a music player, and we get the music CD. And I'm just going to quickly explain how to get more of those music CDs. If you want more of them, you actually have to trade in the highest rank food items back at the Panda Inn. So if you want to do that, do it. It's not really that amazing, it's just a few music tracks. Not even sure how to use it. Oh, there isn't even a disc inserted, so I can't use it, it seems. Oh well. Okay, but seriously now, the Galindo fight.
Come back, Winevs!
Hey there.
I'm a bit under-leveled, but it shouldn't be a problem. Yes, yes! My body is ready for the ring.
They call me Galindo! I have no regrets, only hopes!
So, mostly what he does is he jumps at you, and of course he's going to do it faster and faster as time goes on. Tastes his G attack, of course. He does a lot of damage as you have seen in my first attempt in episode 3, I think. So, yeah, don't really let him attack you too much. And he also has a grapple attack, which if he catches you, he dashes some damage. Of course, using the dark magic that we got from Zahar, it's pretty nice. As you can see, it can deal damage fast. It's not how much it does, it's actually how fast it can dash it out. That's the best part about it. It's really weird the timing on that attack, since you have to jump right before he lands. Like that. And he's down.
Alwen, you've grown so much.
And we get a pretty important item. I'm surprised. You've grown so much in the short time. Truly magnificent. I shed a single tear at your beautiful performance. The proof of your victory here. Allow me to present you with this. A level plate G. Yeah, I'll show it off how to use it. Thank you, I think. Actually, there's someone in this Colosseum whose might eclipses even my own. Seriously? Don't look so surprised. There is always someone greater out there in the world. But don't take my word for it. Seeing is believing, after all. Or would you care to take the ultimate challenge? You know what, let's leave that for later. Alas, are you truly wimping out on me now? Well, have it your way. If you decide you'd like a shot at eternal glory later, the challenge will be here waiting. And I, for one, would be thrilled to see you attempt it. Alright, let me just quickly show the level plate G and what it does. Let's see, let's go back to the entrance of Secunda Mines, why not? If we examine this plate here, we can use the level plate G, and our HP changes from red to purple for some reason, and it's a good indicator that it's activated. It changes the dungeon's level to level 30, and it also increases item drops like those capsules and of course food items even, so it's a pretty nice way to level grind. But more importantly, if we examine our warp, we can see now there is an extra treasure chest For example, at the Magistone Quarry. This is the way you get the last 20 chests in the game, and of course there are some in the final dungeon as well, but I haven't entered there yet. I'm going to do this off screen. They are mostly at the same locations where the previous chests were, so it's not really that interesting. Of course the enemies get stronger. I would recommend to equip the Giver's Beard at all times, since boosting your item drop rate is pretty good. And you get a reward for collecting all the capsules, but sadly that's only on New Game Plus. So I won't be able to do much with that just yet. And while I'm here, might as well check out the Illusory Labyrinth. Level 99, huh? Well, we won't be reaching level 99, like, at all. Since the highest level is actually level 50, but using Alwen's, what's this thing called? The Triumphant Towels. This area is pretty easy to get through. As you can see, these areas are randomly generated each time. Not really that interesting since they all look the same. There are 20 floors to go through. This is the first one. There is a boss at every 10th floor. I'm not going to show them, really. And here is the way to proceed. I sadly didn't find a chest. There are chests everywhere throughout the dungeon sometimes, and they contain food items. And the lower you go, the better the rewards from them are. And sometimes the exit gate is locked and you have to find the switch, which is pretty annoying to be honest. So you might have to end up exploring the entire floor before you can proceed even one level down. As you can see, I'm just tearing through these guys. And here is the switch. Honestly, I would just recommend skipping every enemy with glide gear. This is going to take forever anyway, so might as well. But yeah, let's show off the spiral gear and how much damage it deals. This is without boosting my strength, by the way. Yeah, it's pretty nice.
You're finished.
Alright, let me meet you guys at the 10th floor. Alright, that was actually pretty fast. I didn't run into too many of those witches. And as you can see, I got a bronze medal for clearing the Illusory Labyrinth, Earth. You get a medal after beating 10 floors, then after beating the boss, then after beating another 10 floors, and then beating the final boss.
Whew, time to take a breather.
For now, I recommend to save, absolutely, since I want to get the capsule from the boss, and I really don't want to go through the labyrinth once again to fight him. So yeah. And I also have the beard equipped. This guy is pretty easy. Not much to him. He's going to go down pretty fast. Hopefully I get the drop on the first try. Oh, I got it. Woohoo!
That's my princess.
And we got the silver medal. As you can see, you can't refight him. Oh well. That's what saves are for.
Let's take a break.
Alright, I'll see you guys at floor 20. By the way, we are in the graveyard now. So yeah, it changes up things in between. Here the most annoying enemies are those ghosts, of course.
Not bad for a human.
Alright, leech floor 20. That was actually pretty the hardest dungeon part, I think, in the Illusory Labyrinth, since those ghosts are can pretty easily hit you. Let's see. Let me use my food items. Look at all the tier 4 items I got just from opening those chests through the dungeon. Let's see how high I can get.
Up and away.
And I reached level 30, and that's where I stopped. Look at the experience difference between level 30 and level 31, it's... What is that, 4 million? Yep, it's 4 million, and the highest food item that gives is 165,000. This one gives around 350,000. It would take me a while to reach level 31, and I don't really want to get that high up. I mean, too overpowered. Where is the fun in that? So for now, I'm just going to hoard all these to get the CDs, why not?
Woo! Time to take a breather!
Time to rest again, of course, to get the capsule again. And we actually get a reward from this guy.
Firebolt.
Let's actually use Firebolt.
I'll handle this! Not done yet! Kneel before me! Kneel before me! Yes!
Yeah, these bosses aren't that interesting, I have to say. Maybe I'll play a BGM over these, just to be more interesting and speed it up. Yeah, you know what, let me do that, after this guy. That took forever. And sadly I didn't get the capsule.
What else did you expect?
But we get the Everdark magic, which is an arcanum for the
Dark
this
breath.
One.
Leave it to me.
Let's see.
Dark impulse.
It's actually pretty nice, it has a suction effect on enemies. And it will be useful when grinding for money. Let's see, I'll meet you guys at the end of the Ordeum Shrine, Illusory Labyrinth, or at the 10th floor, I mean. Alright, I reached level 10 in Second Mine, so... Yeah, sure, let's fight the boss. I actually tried to fight that lich like 10 times and he didn't drop the capsule, so I just... said screw it, I'll do it on New Game Plus. Hey, a giant kraken. That was sweet and short. Meet you guys at floor 20.
For the gold!
Alright, floor 20. That was actually pretty damn dangerous. I almost died a few times there.
Ooh, time to take a breather.
As you can see, we are in the castle dungeons. I actually ended up equipping the gourmet chopsticks, since I don't really want to run out of food items. Oh, and there were the slugs that could inflict poison.
Woo! Time to take a breather!
I should probably also equip the Cleria rope since I bought it.
Firebolt!
And for our troubles we get...
What else did you expect?
A new pet, a kobold. 20 is actually the last pet in the main story anyway, in regular game, not New Game Plus. Next up, the Gloomgeld Woods.
I suppose we should rest.
Floor 10 of Gloomgeld Woods Illusory Labyrinth. That was actually a pretty smooth ride, I didn't even get hit.
Wanna rest a little?
Oh, multiple enemies, no problem. That was actually pretty fast too, so this area is pretty nice to farm food items.
Ooh, time to take a breather.
Doesn't take too long, and the enemies aren't that hard. That is a problem. Let's see here. A bit more defense, maybe. Give me the item. This one is actually pretty nice.
You shone like the stars, my princess!
Finders keepers!
The Weasel Suit. It's Ragna's... let's just call it his ultimate weapon. And it actually changes his appearance to a kobold. Should I keep it on? Nah. Just too goofy for my taste. It does boost his attack by 2, if you want.
I suppose we should rest.
And the final area should be at Auron Forge Tower.
Not a bad showing.
Alright, well, that area was a bit harder, but the only reason for that is that they brought back the stone walls instead of those wooden fences that you can just hover over. The stone walls you can break apart, and also because of the flaming cocks. Oh, and that's not me being crude, that's what they are called. They are called flaming cock. Yeah. Thanks, Exceed.
Wanna rest a little?
Actually, let's not repeat what happened last time.
Effort.
10 more floors to go, and I am done with the labyrinth. Finally.
Be sure not to overexert yourself.
Going for the gold!
Alright, that was the final area. And here comes the final boss. Finally. Alright, big guy, come at me. Really? This is what I get as a boss for all my trouble. Oh, he just blew himself up. Okay, works for me.
Wow, you really did it.
And here we get Owen's ultimate armor, the checkered skirt. It's basically a school uniform. Because of course it is. Plus one magic and plus one defense over the Clearia robe. Actually, I never even used this thing, might as well show it off. The portable TV. It's a bit bigger. Get a closer look at characters. That's about it, all it does. And now for the thing that I have been putting off for way too long. I was dreading this moment. Alright, Kappa, time to get this through. And over with. Give me your worst. We have to do the level 2 course twice. Oh well, this one isn't that much different from the first one. There are still no objects that could damage us. We just have to get through and break all the pots once again. By the way, I forgot to mention that you can jump, with the jump button of course, but I didn't mention it because you don't need it for the first two courses. This is the part I always screw up. Did I break them all? I don't know. I missed one, because of course I did. Why wouldn't I? Alright, I show the part when I do it. Screw that pot.
Damn it!
There we go. It was a silver medal. You're a contender, kiddo. And of course, I'll bet you're wondering where a couple of honest means like myself would come by a nice hunk of silver. Making the past, these rich guys, I'm talking about serious loaded, would come to climb the summit of Starry Peak. Of course, they'd get lost, wander around, befuddled for a day or two, then crawled back to their fancy mansion. They tossed their silver watches into the well, wishing to get back home safe, and those got melted down into fancy medals. Quite a tale, ain't it? Yeah, I'm impressed. Yeah, I'm cut at them etchers, maybe so. You up for another go? And I have to do the second course again. True Farcom sometimes, really screw them. I actually decreased the difficulty and I just got all the pots. This is a scam, I tell you. That guy Yasuku is pretty well known in Starfall Hamlet, Not such a big guy. He really has a way of unintentionally sneaking up on a guy, half scared the piss out of me. Does he really have to tromp around wearing that bear pelt? I see a guy like that out of the corner of my eye, and every fiber of my being tells me to run tail and run for the hills. I mean, anyone would be scared if they saw that brute walking toward them with his giant axe and his mane of chest hair, wouldn't you? Anyway, you up for another go? Sadly I am, but that actually added a character note for the Kappa and for Yasaku. And here we go, now he will start adding traps into the courses. Let me just show you my first try, I'm probably going to fail. I think I'm actually going to intentionally make this easier. I think I would call this the hardest one out of the four. Yeah, you can't even take damage. And there was a pot I just missed, so eh. Oh, and now you have to also jump, and there is another pot down there. Actually, I think they replaced the pots with these statues. Yeah, this one is a real bitch. Yeah, this is going to take a while. Yeah, I had to decrease the difficulty. I have no shame. I don't care. Not bad for at all a real capstone achievement, honest. You really hung in there, and by the way of recognizing your guts and glory, I got a little something nice for you. I guess you are pretty much clear this one, no doubt about it. But I ain't clean out the tricks out yet. I got another challenge ready for you to tackle. If you are feeling frisky, you are welcome to hit the slopes anytime. Aurora magic? What is this doing in it? Way back when a pretty lady asked me to hold on to that. Yep yep, that staff you got there is the dead ringer for the one she said we had. But you know, I've been holding on to it for so long now, I would have been anticlimactic just to give it to you. And since I know how much you love that rush of winning a race by the skin of your teeth after 20 tries, I made it a prize. Well, to level with ya, I forgot I had it till I found it in the back of my closet yesterday, right underneath my thermal underwear. Anyhow, you like giving it another go? And that upgrade that is last character note, and there is one more course to clear. Okay, shut up about Alwen's mom, please. And this one is actually a semi-race. I'm gonna hit the slopes with you this time. That weird gizmo you got there is pretty tricksy, but I know a few tricks myself. Oh, tell you what, I'll even go easy on ya since you are my best customer and all. Alright, let's do this thing. Go easy on me, huh? Screw you. I actually got all the pots on this the normal way without cheating and decreasing the difficulty once, but I didn't get to go first in the finishing line, so I lost anyway. And this was the wrong, or was it? Actually, I think I saw a pot over there, so it might have been the right way. Yeah, this isn't happening anytime soon. See ya when I do it. What? Did I do it? Wait. No. Wait. Screw you. I hate you. Finally did it. Ooh, the platinum medal. You got us a big shot right here. Good job there. Beating me on my home turf is really something. And it's only fair that they, in celebration of your big moment of triumph, I reward you, right? Well, crap. I don't have anything else. Looks like I'll have to dig into my personal collection for something. Well, you might be kinda surprised to get something like this, but... here, take it. A model of Rue? See, I knew you'd be surprised. Totally called it. This here is what you might call my secret figure. It's ultra rare, so everyone who sees it naturally takes aback. Truly a crown jewel for any serious collector. Well, go on, take it, and treasure it each day as you very own. I doubt I'll ever come across another. And we are done. Finally, finally done with that awful minigame. And all we got is a model of Rue. And we also don't have to do it on New Game Plus again since the models carry over, thank God. Before I end today's episode, I actually want to show off something. This is where we fought the boss at Starry Peak. Hey, Tenze, Gramps! You came to check on you, are you alright? Ah, it's you too. You don't need to worry about me, it's just at my age, it does take a while to bounce back from something like that. Beyond my own health, though, I'm afraid matters have become quite grave. There's no doubt this was the very situation you Geekard feared. You mean with the Spiral Fortress? Indeed, once it makes its move, all will fall to ruin. But here, we are still recovering from the recent attack. In this state, I fear we can't be of much help, young Ragna, Princess Alwen. I ask that you see this triumph to the end. Come on, you don't need to worry about us. But I want to thank you for keeping your promise with my father all this time. We've got things under control, I think. I ain't exactly brimful of confidence here, but we've got lots of good people backing us up. So just sit tight and take it easy, Gramps. Take it easy, you say? Well then, I'll leave things in your capable hands. Once again, we must ask for your aid. Will do. And one more thing. I'm currently at the area where those light bulbs were, and I'm heading back to the end of the dungeon. This is where we got the gear in the Star Beak. And I'm coming here for a special reason. In this area, let's just break all the pots so that the enemies drop down. Actually, I don't think it matters here. Anyhow, I'm doing it anyway.
Duck and cover!
There we go, that's all the pots broken now. All the enemies are free to roam around. And if we go back out and come back in... And if we come back, you find that all the pots are still broken and the enemies are wandering around still. And if we use Dark Impulse, which is the art that we just got this episode... It sucks all the enemies in, and if you do this on the level 30 version of this dungeon, in particular, you can get a whole bunch of penne. Yeah, that's a pretty good farming spot, and you can just leave this area and come back really easily by just going through the gate and coming back. And you don't even have to worry about your Arcanum points, since the Dark Impulse will generate enough combos to get you another one. And you just repeat this of course on the higher difficulty. Maybe equip the designer purse.
Please, bear us away.
And before next time, of course, I'm going to go through all the dungeons and getting all the treasure chest that I still need from the G-plate. But can we break through Mercedes' impenetrable air current and reach Thermidor and Mia? Find out next time on Let's Play 2, The Ilvard Insurrection. Thank you guys for tuning in. Until then, have a good one.